Creating a diverse bookshelf and placing everything manually on it can be a tiresome and repetitive task. This motivates me to design a set of rules that can somewhat resemble the patterns of certain real-life bookshelves. Here's how it works. All bookshelves of any shape have these singular cells. Depending on how you define them, they can be different in sizes and areas. From here, we classify all cells into two main groups, homogeneous and heterogeneous, or unmixed and mixed, for shorter terminology. And this is the result we're supposed to have after we classify them. But why? Because there are three generated classes in this system: vertical books, horizontal books, and the item placement. From condition 1 and 2, we decide the simple rules are: the unmixed cells can host only one out of the three mentioned classes, and the mixed cells are allowed to host all three of them. This simple rule, combined with controllable parameters, can allow for rather diverse and colorful generated results. To sum up, here's what's gonna happen inside Houdini. First, we'll decide how the cell patterns look like. After that, we'll classify the cells into different group types. And finally, we'll generate three data classes based on the cell type. So essentially, that's how it works. Let's dive into the actual ACA packet itself. We have the basic shapes with a quick pattern. I quickly built into an ACA here. You can make it a bit more interesting by offset the values to 1. Next, drop down a copy to shelf. If you think you know why I named this node like this, you are right. It is inspired from the native copy to voice of in Houdini and works, or something like that. In the shelf tab, turn on visualize type. This will allow you to see how you classify the cells before generating anything. Turn on type attribute in copy to shelf to see the actual types being displayed here. By default, we are in mix mode. Therefore, you can see that all the cells are mixed and can host three generated data classes in each. Switch to unmixed, then you have the opposite like we discussed. Switch to both, then you have both. Depending on what you need, we have all the parameters to statistically control everything you intend to in a precise way. For example, the parameter here determines the percentage of mixed cells, as you can see in the viewport. Right now, we're gonna leave it at unmixed mode, and I think it's pretty clear as I change the percentage of these two parameters. You can see what's going on. It's all about the percentage. If you just want the item, you have all the item. If you want the vertical book, you have the vertical book, and vice versa. For the mixed mode, we demonstrate on just one single cell, so you can see better what we're doing. And it's pretty much the same thing. We have the percentage control to redirect what we want to have. And if you have multiple cells, this parameter number will be applied to all of them. You might be wondering, isn't that kind of repetitive? Because all the cells have the same values applied to them. Well, that's up to you to decide, because you can change these values per cell by using the prim number attribute with the new workflow tops to generate different values, or just with the detailed iteration of the for loop. If you're in both mode, then obviously this is gonna give you a more diverse looking result, and you have all the controls for this as well. In the book tab, you can further customize the way how your books look. For example, changing the density of the books, you have the size min-max, the initial tilting of the books, and another additional layer of the tilting. I call it the lazy slide. Right now, everything looks uniform because it's in uniform mode. The random option can give you a more rugged look. For the horizontal books, you have pretty much the same thing. To offset slightly the position of the book, just to get rid of that generated loop. If it's inconvenient to switch between horizontal and vertical, you can turn on both, so you can have all the parameters presented. For the item tab, you have the scaling to determine how your item should fit with the shelf, the seat to change the item placement, the orient. This tab works universally for all items that you're gonna plug in here. If you want to modify exactly how each item should appear in your shelf, the item importer node will be your friend. For example, you just want the pick hat to appear one time in your shelf, you can set that number. Now I will set it to 1. If you want all the items imported to appear just one time without going by each tab, imagine if you have hundreds of items, this is gonna be a very tedious task. Well, we have this handy little icon here and it will take care of everything. Once you're happy with your setup, turn up proxy preview and drop our BookKit material node. In this node, just point to your book texture folder and it will automatically scan every texture you have in the folder to assign the texture to each book. You will have a C to change the texture assignment, the page color here. And voila, that's pretty much it. If you like to have your material set up in the map context and modify even further, there is this option over here. Right now, it supports Redshift shader and principal shaders, which works both for Karma and Mantra, but you can always create your own material suited for your rendering engines and it will work just the same. Now, we will go over quickly the steps to build the promotion bookshelves you see in the teaser. As you can see, they are very simple setups, but can give you decent results. Since everything is procedural, you don't need to build things the way I just showed you guys. I would actually and highly recommend that you create your own patterns or even modify the one I provided. I only did this AGA, the quick pattern, in a couple of hours, so you can imagine that it's rather simple. But it does give you an idea where to go and generate interesting results just by changing a few tiny things. So yeah, please let your creativity at work since these are designed to take and receive openly. The limitation is really your own imagination.